Welcome to Kids for Christ here at the Fort Bend Church. I'm Mr. Reverend Haywood. Okay, I want you to follow my instructions. Ready? Stand up. Now I want you to sit down. Stand up. You may be wondering why I ask you to stand, jump, and sit. Well, today our Bible story is about obeying God and following His instructions. Today we will see if Moses followed God's instructions. Do you think Moses obeyed or disobeyed God? Last week, we learned a new big picture question. What is God like? Do you remember the answer? That's right. The answer is God is holy, good, and loving. As you hear today's Bible story, I want you to watch and listen for ways God showed He is holy, good, and loving. God's people were already in a hard place. They had been to the edge of the promised land and refused to go in. So God sent them into the wilderness to wander for 40 years. Still, God was with His people and provided for them. Today's story is called Moses Disobeyed God and comes from the Old Testament book of Numbers. Why would Moses do that? Let's find out what went wrong.
The Israelites did not trust God to lead them into the Promised Land, so God made them wander in the wilderness for 40 years. God's people set up camp, but there was no water to drink. And the people complained and argued with Moses. "Why did you bring us here?" they asked. "We will die here, and so will our animals." The people wished that they had never left Egypt. The wilderness had no grain, no fruit, and no water. So Moses and Aaron went to the tabernacle to meet with God. God told Moses and Aaron to stand in front of all the people and speak to a rock. God said that water would come out of the rock. Then the people and the animals would have water to drink. So Moses called all the people together and he stood in front of that rock. But instead of talking to the rock, he told the group, "Listen up. Do we have to bring water out of this rock for you?" And then Moses hit the rock twice with his staff, and water poured out, and the people and the animals drank. But God was angry that Moses and Aaron did not obey His instructions. They did not honor Him as holy by trusting in His power. So God said that Moses and Aaron would not lead the Israelites into the Promised Land. Instead, God would give His people a new leader. Moses disobeyed God and did not enter the Promised Land. We have all disobeyed God by sinning, but God gave us His Son, Jesus. Jesus always obeyed God, and when we trust in Him, Jesus brings us into God's kingdom forever.
Why did the Israelites complain to Moses? In Numbers chapter 20, verses 2 through 5, the Israelites were very, very thirsty and needed water for their animals too. The wilderness was a dry and desolate place, similar to the desert. The Israelites couldn't just go to the store to buy supplies they needed to find a water source. But there was no good water anywhere close. They were desperate. The Israelites began arguing, complaining, and doubting God's faithfulness to provide. God gave Moses two specific instructions. In verses 7 and 8, Moses obeyed the first instruction, but the second instruction is where he disobeyed. Moses decided to strike the rock instead of speaking to it. Moses' disobedience made God angry. Because Moses did not obey God, Moses would not be allowed to enter into the promised land. It wasn't just that Moses did not do what God asked. His actions reveal that he did not trust God. God wanted to show his holiness, but Moses had claimed he and Aaron would bring water from the rock. God is serious about sin. Like Moses, we too have consequences for our disobedience. But the good news is God gave us his son Jesus to take our sin upon himself on the cross. When we trust in him, our sins are forgiven, and we can enter into the promised land of eternity. Our Christ connection says that Moses disobeyed God and didn't enter the promised land. We all have disobeyed God by sinning, but God gave us his son, Jesus. Jesus always obeys God. When we trust him, he brings us into God's kingdom forever. Later, when you watch the Questions for Kids video, think about these questions. Why was it a big deal that Moses hit the rock? And do you take all sin seriously? Why or why not? Our mission moment tells us that God had compassion on his people and provided water. But when Moses disobeyed God, his sin had consequences. Our sin has consequences too, and we can only be forgiven through Jesus. Many people in the world have never heard of Jesus. We often refer to people like this as unreached. Today, we're going to learn about Samuel Zwemer, a man who felt so much compassion for unreached people that he spent most of his life far from his home country as a missionary. Last week, we introduced our new key passage from Exodus 15:11. It shows us about who God is and what he is like. I hope you worked on memorizing the key passage because memorizing scripture is important, as it helps us to remember the truth about who God is, what he is like, and how we can always trust him. Now I want you to repeat the key passage after me. Lord, who is like you among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, revered with praises, performing wonders? Exodus 15:11. Now, let's sing the key passage song together, Who is Like You, and then we'll sing our worship song, God Keeps His Promises. Wow, it is so much fun singing the Key Passage song. I hope you sing it this week because, as always, it's a great way to help us to remember our key passage. Now it's prayer time. Let us pray. Father, thank you for your word and how it teaches us to trust you. Help us to follow Jesus' example in his obedience to you. We love you and praise you for always providing for our needs. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Now it's time for the Questions from Kids video. After the video, look at the Missions Moments photo of Samuel Zwamer and read the story with your parents. Then work on your activity pages, and if you need help, ask your parent. This week I want you to pray, thanking God for missionaries like Samuel Zwamer and missionaries supported by the churches around the world. Remember to subscribe to the Fort Bend Church YouTube channel, like and share this week's video, and have a great week.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Joel from Aurora, Illinois asks,
why was it a big deal that Moses hit the rock? It seems unfair for God to not let him go into the promised land.
Oh, that's a hard question to answer there. But in short, it was right for God not to allow Moses to enter the promised land. And he hit the rock because he was angry. You see, the Lord tells us don't sin in our anger. And so Moses found himself in the midst of a sinful and evil heart, not only towards the people that he was dealing with, but also towards God. You see, God had given really clear instructions to hit the rock once. But Moses, in his anger, oftentimes like we are when we're angry, we do things that we should not do. And so the consequence of his sin was that he would never enter the promised land. You see, our parents often give us rules, they give us regulations, they give us ways to follow and to be obedient. And when we don't follow what our parents and teachers and others say, there's often consequences for our sins. You see, not only do little kids experience consequences, but adults likewise experience consequences, especially consequences from the Lord when he has told us really, really clear in the Bible what we should and what we should not do. You see, disobedience always leads to consequences. God will always give us consequences when we break his holy and righteous law. You see, God takes our disobedience really seriously because he wants us to be holy and he wants us to be righteous. He wants us to stand before him with pure and clean and sincere hearts. So, do you take all sin seriously? Why? Or why not?
Let's use this bowl of cereal to show you the spread of Christianity around the world. Green represents Christianity, and red represents where the gospel has never been. Since the resurrection of Jesus, the gospel has spread across the world. But there are still many people who have never heard the gospel. Close to one-third of the world has still never heard. Another term used to describe this is unreached. This map shows the locations of people most in need of access to the gospel. And this map illustrates the progress of engaging unreached peoples. Rejoice in how the gospel is spreading among unreached people groups. And pray for those who still remain unreached with the gospel.